Okay, here I am back again with my spiritual experiences. This is part 3 of that series where I will talk about my spiritual experiences in the best way I can. And again, sorry for my speaking here and there, that sometimes it's some words are not that clear because I am talking sometimes too fast on that moment, or my thoughts are faster than I cannot catch up sometimes with my thoughts. So okay, in part 2 I had spoken about my experiences with the mantis being, and normally I said that I wanted to give that name. I will look at it if I can find him. I will wait. Otherwise, no. I will wait. I will do it in part 4. I will in the video part 4. I will give that person. Documentary about the mantis beings. If you are interested, you can explore it. But okay, so yes, that was my second experience around 2009. And also, I had much to say. I have also. Dream-like kind of experiences. For example, sometimes in my dreams I can also, especially recently, it's not for say that I, in every dream I have, I am able to do that. You know, it's like I can sometimes lift up objects, you know, or I can suddenly go into the sky, for example. So a kind of flying, I can elevate myself. Yeah? So yes, I have a lot of those also, this kind of situations in my dreams. Okay, but must I say. To say it in short, in general, about my dreams, that I can move objects. And the first time I did this, that was also around that period of time, between 2010, I think, that in dreams I somebody, you know, don't ask me how this person, it's just a human beings also, but don't ask me how they look like, or I don't know. I can't remember, but I know that they were helping me to elevate through thought, you know, objects. And yes, it was not easy to do, you know, but at the end, at that moment, I could do it. It was like in the head, you know, and I must try to put it on the, when you hang your vest on, your jacket on, something like that. It was in the head, and I must put it on the when you put your clothes on, you know. And yeah, it was okay. It was difficult, but it was okay. And then they gave me presents and or whatever. I don't know. It was like that, you know. They gave me presents and. Okay, so thank you. Then suddenly at my right side, it was like I saw like an arena outside, you know, and it was like a gate that was open, and I saw some boy or so coming. He saw me and he says, I think he called it by my name. That now by my name that I have, and he recognized me, you know. But I can recall now that I recognize him, so I cannot recall that. But I went to him, you know. It was running to me, you know. Hey, very exciting. And then suddenly the gates, I must say, somebody prevented me from coming to entering, you know, that arena, and because I was not allowed. That's the impression that I had. So the doors, the gate was closed front my eyes, you know, so I cannot enter it. More I do not remember, but that was also one of these experiences. And so yes, then in my dreams, over the years, I could elevate. I've tried, you know, and it's like you train to remember your dreams. It's like doing like that, you know, it's training, eh? And so I train myself also to like I do this. I have a very I must say it's possible to do it here also, but this is much difficult here than in your dreams, you know. It's another situation. So over the years I've learned that to do that and to elevate myself, to fly, you know. And so more and more it becomes easier. And like I said, it's not in every dream that I have that. And but also another thing also, I was must I say, I will say it after this, also I have learned to, or it is suddenly, you know, some things, you know, that is possible and you can do it. It's like I can also must I say, have a control over somebody, you know. I had this two times, a little bit of weird, strange dreams, you know. I don't know, but it was not manipulating a human being. It was something else, you know. Some I don't know. I was in a car or so, in the back of the car, and we passed this, you know, on the road, and then at the back of me I saw some creatures, you know, and one of these creatures I did like this. No, and this creature do like this, you know. It's like I put it at sleep also. That's one of the examples. Another example in another dream was like I don't know, it's kind of at work or somewhere, and some machine came to me. It was floating, you know, came to me, and I don't know what happened, but I did like this, you know, that it must go away. So through thought I could let's say order, to give orders to that machine to go away, and then I could lift myself. This he did go away, or that machine did go away, and I lifted myself up through sometimes I can do that through my hands, to lift myself up and to floating, you know, moving in the air, you know, so much above the ground or so. I can do that. I have that in other dreams also, a lot, you know. And so yes, my dreams are also very interesting in that manner. but yes, I never tried to lift myself up in this situation. I have not tried to do that, or that I have tried in to meditate and to lift myself up, but I never was able to do that. Thought Stephen Greer was talking about his experience. Stephen Greer, you can find him also. He was like in a couple of days, you know, in the meditative state, and he says that when you are expanding your consciousness, you know, and you are not stuck on this belief system that we have here, or the what we are so used to, you know, You go beyond that, and he was floating above the ground, and he says also that when your belief system comes in, that closes the door again to that ability. So now he went down the ground again, now, and it's like it's like to me it's like a sort of program that prevent us to enter these abilities, you know. So like belief systems is also a kind of program, you know. So in general, in these dreams I have that, you know, I have other issues also. For example, that in my dreams also with the military that I had, confrontation, like helicopters, you know. And once I saw, in my dream, I was walking with a dog, with my dog, the same one that I have now, in an open field, and not in the field, but in the surroundings of nature. And then some black helicopter comes over and I think 20 meters distance of where I was, and then going like this, it's just maybe 2 meters, I cannot say for sure, you know, it can be 4 meters or so above the ground, looking at me. And of course, it was very clear windows, so I could see who was in it. I saw three of them in these helicopters, and the clothes were, it was obvious military, maybe like a desert kind of look of the clothes. Maybe navy, I don't know, it's possible, but it's very interesting, you know. And sometimes I have the feeling that also here sometimes helicopters, black ones, but that's not a certainty, it's just, you know, I'm always be careful what I say in that matter, but it's possible, eh? It's just very interesting, and but it's not the first time in my dreams I have conflicts or confrontation with black helicopters, and sometimes it attacks, you know. Sometimes people come in my home, and it's another home than this one, and sometimes shooting at my home. But that was only once. And I know when that happens, somebody says outside, hooligans, you know, it's very strange. But also when I am out, you know, flying around, and then in that one dream, I saw a helicopter, but with two, not one, but two, I cannot, what the name of that helicopter calls with two, you know, it also was also a black one, kind of color, I think dark brown or black, undecided, close to the color black. And it was me that confronted them, and with my thoughts, you know, I picked the helicopter up, you know, because I was angry at some moment, I don't know, for some reason. Then I put it loose, and then go away. But at the end, then again, I was landing, I think. Sometimes when I am flying, you know, I am very difficult to land. Sometimes it's no problem, and mostly I have a problem with it, to lift myself up and go in the air. I have not that much of a trouble, but to land I have more trouble with it. But yes, on that moment I was landing, you know, no problem. And then No, I meant to going to an like a kind of shop or so, a cafe, I don't know what it was, but I wanted to enter it. Some people were up front at the door, say, what's the problem here? And then I look back at me, I saw like a SWAT team. And that was the kind of impression that I had, the coming after me. I don't know what it was, but it was all with weapons. And then it threw a kind of bomb at us. And it went off, but at the moment that it went off, that is very interesting. I did what with my right hand to stop it or to block it from hitting me. So, but it went off, and it's like that kind of the kind of shock I felt. You can compare it with back then the PlayStation kind of. When something you are playing the PlayStation, and you have especially with these games when you fight games, you know, and some bomb goes off, or with your car you go crash your car, you feel at that knob the shock, you know, the vibration, your joystick vibrates, you know, when you hit something in the game. So that kind of feeling, but more intense. And then I could escape, but they were still after me. And then I went to it's sometimes difficult to imagine, you know, these situations. To recall it, I can recall it, but it's difficult to explain. It's a little bit crazy. But yes, these kind of dreams, you know, sometimes I have. But this one was the first one that I could, must I say, prevent that the bomb of whatever it went off, that I was affected by it, so I could stop it in a way. That it touches me, so that was the first experience in that way. So yeah, it's very interesting dreams. So at the end, I will always go to the bottom of it, but it all the reality of it, you know. So I will go. And find for answers, you know, because like I said, some people experience. If this video falls out, I will create part 4. I will go further on it. But like I said, many people have let's say one lifetime experience. They saw something in the sky, what we call UFO, for example. And some people doing meditation practices, or and they have then a hard time to reach to experience something, you know. But in my case, it's unbelievable. In different areas, you know, it's unbelievable what I have been going through. And for me, it's not a shock. No, on the contrary, I am not shocked by it. I am, for me, it's more a shock that I discovered back in 2008-9 what the system really is about, and who's pulling the strings. Not who, but the attitude. You know, who is pulling the strings? What is their motivation? And when I was going down more and more deeper in the rabbit hole about my own experiences, and listen to speakers like David Icke, Ronnie Kilder, Jordan Maxwell, for example, I was back then very shocked what was going on behind the scenes, and I was very angry at that time. Now I am more stabilized because I understand more on a deeper level, but still, I am the anger is still there in some way, but in a positive way. Okay. So but about in that dream that I could control some entity or so, in a way. I saw that movie recently also, Lucy, for example, that movie. And she, some of the materials, though, that was put in her body, and because of an accident, you know, or a fight, struggle, that material that was in her body was getting loose in her bloodstream, so and then in her DNA or something, because of that material. What kind of material it was. I did not deep research on it, but a little bit of give a little bit not fully, but answers, you know, what in that project was. But yes, it activates her ability and her brain capacity, you know, capacity. So and also she says when you are on 50% or 60% or was it less, 40%, I don't know, you can control somebody, you know, you can manipulate somebody by saying you turn around and go away. For example, that person will do that. Now it reminded me when I rewatched that movie. It reminded me when she said that of my experience, you know, in that dream that I could manipulate that creature or that robot kind of thing in the other dream. So, but in reality, yeah, of course you can do that, but I would never do that to control somebody, you know, only when it's needed, when there is danger, maybe, for the safety of your own or others, you know, but at the end, so yes, about that, I had, my dreams are very interesting also, like a sort of vision, in a vision kind of way, you know. I can remember some of it, the situations, and like I said, you know, it can be genuine or it can be put in your head in some way. So I always be careful on that subject, on the experiences that you have in your dreams. At the side, you know, I have also experiences that are here, you know, that I was lying in my bed and then suddenly I wake up and somebody is busy, you know, or is present in my room and does something with me, you know. I have a lot of them also. Not always pleasant, you know. It's like also in first week of my, okay, that's long enough, 23 minutes, but in the next video I will talk about it, about my experiences that in this reality here, you know, when I just woke up and something is on my body or does something with me. I will talk about that it in part 4, okay? So part 3 was more about my dreams and the ability to elevate myself or to move objects. It's very and some conflict with the military guys, you know. I don't know why, of course, in reality, they are interested in people who have experiences with some kind of way, with entities or the ability that we have. You know, it can be in various ways, like remote viewing, for example, can also be a reason. But So, I just wanted to share this, you know. And so see you then in part four with the other experiences that I had. So, see you then.